I don't remember a day in my life, not a single day, where I wasn't conscious of the fact that I was born a lucky little Kiwi girl in a country where there was everything that I needed, food on the table, education, health, safety, people who loved me. And yet, if I'd been born a little girl somewhere else in the world, my life would have been so profoundly different. I believe absolutely that no matter where you're born, you're entitled to the same essential service delivery. And that belief has run right through the whole journey of Adara over the last 21 years. And I studied law and thought I would work doing human rights law all my life into an examination of power and how money and power move in society. I had a big moment when I was finishing my law degree where I realised there's this huge hole in my knowledge base around power and capital, and decided I was going to go learn Wall Street, learn investment banking, learn money and power. And that has been the most joyous and incredibly interesting journey, because of course once I stepped out of my tribe, I immediately recognised my prejudice and found that actually in the world of power and capital, there's a huge amount of intent to affect change, a huge amount of integrity. The movement of power and money is a really important thing to understand if we want to affect change.
What would you say if I told you that a corporate finance business working in the investment banking markets was integral in turning around the life of this child and thousands of others?
Adara was born of the crazy idea that we could build corporate advice businesses working with the most advantaged people on the planet, and use them for the sole purpose of supporting the most disadvantaged people on the planet. People thought we were drug dealers or money launderers. They really did not believe that this was an appropriate use of business in the world. Human rights and social justice still sit at the heart of everything I do, but now I get the great fun of being in the game as well and using that background and that experience to benefit people, amazing heroes in extreme poverty around the world. I will not stop fighting for the rights of women and girls until the day where every single little girl wakes up and knows that she has the opportunity, the same opportunity as every single little boy, to make our world a kinder, more inclusive place. If you're leading people, you get a chance to speak to their higher self, or you get a chance to bring them down, be the best person that you can be, to inspire others, to support others, to unleash talent. And there is amazing talent everywhere that sits underneath you that you can unleash, and that can exceed what you can do. You have to be better than you really are, because that's what your team needs from you. That's what the world needs from you. We're 100 miles deep in our work with preemie babies, low birth weight babies in places without consistent electricity supply. That work centred in a centre of excellence in Uganda, where we've been working for 21 years, I believe is going to ultimately touch hundreds of thousands, millions more lives. So there'll be a lot deeper service and a lot more knowledge sharing. Think completely outside of the box. And the next thing is, and never ever take no for an answer. Don't let anybody stop you. It requires intention, and it requires manifesting really unusual ways of thinking. But I have huge faith in the next generation of leaders. I think that our world is going to be profoundly changed for the better by the young leaders that are coming through as the dinosaurs roll off. There's a lot that needs to be done in our fractured world. 800 million people live in extreme poverty. So we have more work to do, all of us, our one stitch each, and I'm not stopping anytime soon. I'm a feminist activist, and I profoundly believe that we have to fight for human rights every single day. Our tagline is Bridging Worlds, and that's because I profoundly believe that if we are going to stand on hills throwing stones at each other, and really if you look at what's happening in our world, our polarizing world right now, that's what's happening, we're never going to make change. We need to build bridges, not walls. That message is more important now, I think, than ever. And that's what Adara symbolizes.